how to keep your fat loss progress after your diet. This is where people struggle the most. It's not necessarily getting the fat off, it's keeping the body fat off. Now, the way that you keep the body fat off is by doing what's called the reverse diet. This is the diet you do after the diet. This is part of it. This is how you sustain your progress. Now, a reverse diet is slowly and incrementally increasing your calories over the course of time, over the course of weeks. So I would suggest adding in 10 to 25 grams of carbs and 5 to 10 grams of fat. Now, the reason why you want to do this incrementally and not just start adding in, you know, 500, 600 calories is because if you do that, you're going to blow up. Your body's going to blow up. You're going to retain a ton of water. You're going to start packing on body fat very, very, very quickly. What happens when you're dieting is your metabolism slows down. So if you start adding in a ton of food, your body's not going to be able to metabolize it because your metabolism got so slow. So you can't do that. Your body's not going to be able to handle all that food. So when you incrementally and slowly add back more food, your body's going to be able to adjust so that it doesn't have to pack on so much body fat. So you'll slowly be able to get back to eating normally without so much excess body fat gain. This is not a time for you to be intuitively eating and just listening to your body, because what your body is actually doing is after the diet, it's going to trick you into thinking that it needs more food. When you're dieting, your body's in a starvation mode, so it doesn't want to be starving anymore. So of course, it's going to give you these signals that you're hungry just so that you can give it more food and then it can hoard all the body fat. So it's smarter. It's smart. It's going to hoard all that food and store it as fat because it doesn't want to be starving anymore. So the next time you diet, this is the worst part. Next time you diet, it's going to be even harder for you to get leaner because your body has stored all that excess body fat so that it's prepared to last longer the next time you starve it, so the next time you diet. So it's going to be harder for you to lose weight in the long term. So you got to really, really, really be careful with how you go about your post-diet. You need to reverse diet. This is not something that you can just take lightly. It's very important for sustaining your progress and to get your metabolism working fast again. And also, you will find that your body is actually going to get leaner too, even though you're eating more food. That's your metabolism speeding up. That's your energy. You know, you're going to feel a lot better. You're going to look better. So take this seriously. I'm warning you, I've been there. I've done this already. You know, I've ignored the reverse diet and just ate intuitively. And of course, I gained a ton more body fat. So guys, slowly reverse yourself out of the diet, just how you slowly started to lose the body fat. So thank you guys for watching. This is how you train your body to eat more food and not gain a ton of body fat. So this is very important after your diet to keep your fat loss results and not gain it all back. Comment below if you need some more tips on the reverse diet, and I will get to that down below. And don't forget to like, share this video, and I will see you in the next one.